Welcome to another exciting edition of the FIU Music Hour, brought to you by the Florida International University School of Music. This program features Florida International University students, faculty, alumni, and friends in a live performance and broadcast from the WDNA Jazz Gallery, located at 2921 Coral Way in Miami. If you are local to the Miami area, we invite you to come to the studio and be part of our live audience. All performances are free and open to the public. Otherwise, please join us on the radio or view the live performance via WDNA's video live stream channel. For this episode, we are delighted to present a modern perspective of traditional and folkloric music from Venezuela. The ensemble is dedicated to the cultivation and promotion of traditional Venezuelan songs. The group is led by Luciana Kube. The four-member ensemble consists of vocals, piano, and cello. Luciana brings an entirely new and eclectic experience in presenting years of timeless songs from Latin American composers. And all of these songs heard are personal arrangements from the minds of the band members themselves. I am your host, Colin Miller, and for your listening pleasure, here is Luciana Kube and her ensemble with their first selection. Take it away, guys.
Verás al viento lamer la tierra de los caminos y de un vistazo verás el trazo de los insectos bordando el aire y el oro en polen maduro y fino del corazón de las margaritas y los aromas recopilados que te esperaron por luengos años. A tu regreso tendrás la sombra fresca y redonda de los laureles. La flor devora blanca y fluctuante que se vacila sobre los pozos. Y el zumo noble, verde y rebelde del limonero que está en el patio. Por las tardes la brisa fina que se entretiene peinando palmas. A tu regreso traerás aquel pedazo de algo que estuvo ayer tumbando mangos como a las tres, chupando caña y robando miel. A tu regreso traerás aquí lo que llevaste dentro de mí, la lula llena como un melón y de la vida nuestra razón. Tu regreso verás la tumba de los pilones que ayer usamos, la resiedumbre de los horcones que nos mantienen en pie en la casa y los gallitos de los bucares que recogías yendo a la escuela y el rostro seco de los aljibes que nos premiaban brotando el agua. A tu regreso verás cocuyos que no se apocan ante una estrella. Y el humo alegre de los fogones rojeando brasas por tu llegada. Y en las auroras un cielo urgido robando azul a los azulejos que abandonaron a los naranjos cuando te fuiste hace 10 años. A tu regreso verás aquel pedazo de algo que estuvo ayer tumbando mangos como a las 3, chupando caña y robando miel. A tu regreso traerás aquí lo que llevaste dentro de ti, la luna llena como un melón y de la vida nuestra razón.
Thank you so much. Thank you for inviting us here. The song we performed is Henry Martinez's composition, A Tu Regreso. In the arrangement is Luisea creation. He is a very important and remarkable guitar player and arranger and a musical figure in our country.
So before we go on here, allow me to introduce this wonderful ensemble. So of course we have Luciana Kube on vocals, and we're about to hear in a minute Carlos Silva on vocals, and on the cello that was Germán Marcano on cello and Clara Marcano on piano. So what are we going to hear next?
The next song is Criollísima. This is a Venezuelan merengue composed by two of the most remarkable composers in our country. They are Henry Martinez and Luis Laguna. Venezuelan merengue, Criollísima.
Plaza vienes tú, las flores se muestran alegres, capullos botones brotan para ti. Huele esa piña madura, aroma exquisito que las frutas nuestras dan. Tienes toda la belleza de un campo florido, de una thank you. temprano por la plaza vienes tú. Las flores se muestran alegres, capullos, botones brotan para ti. Hueles a piña madura, aroma exquisito que las frutas nuestras dan. Tienes toda la belleza de un campo florido, de un atardecer. La ira, la ira.
Wow, what powerful vocals, great arrangement, beautiful song. So what are we hearing next? I believe it's El Viajero?
Yes, El Viajero is a part of a collection of songs, a group of songs that Vicente Emilio Sojo put all together, and we can call them our Venezuelan romanticism, this musical collection. This is a beautiful song from the eastern of the Venezuela, from the eastern coast. It's a canción, a song from Margarita, from a beautiful island in the east part of the country.
All right, take it away.
Extraño piloto, condujo tu barca sin remo y sin ancla. ¿De qué región vienes? ¿Quién hizo pedazos tus velas tan blancas? Partiste cantando y vuelves trayendo la muerte.
Thank you.
viajero que alegre del puerto salió una mañana, llevando tan solo por hábil piloto mi dulce esperanza. Yo fui a buscar perlas y hoy náufrago vengo sin remo y sin ancla. Y vuelvo trayendo collares muy blancos tan solo de lágrimas, tan
another great song with a beautiful sound. So this next song is actually going to be a solo piece featuring Clara Marcano on piano. And the song is Caramba, and the composer is Otilio Galindez, and the arrangement is by Luis Zia. So Clara, take it away. All right, that was Clara Marcano on piano with Caramba. So we're going to be taking a short break now, but don't go away. When we come back, we are going to be interviewing Luciana Kube and her wonderful ensemble. You're listening to the FIU Music Hour here on WDNA. We'll be right back after these messages. Stick around. Thank you. Okay, welcome back to the FIU Music Hour, brought to you live from WDNA 88.9 FM. And here we have Luciana Kube presenting a modern perspective of folkloric Venezuelan music. Now it's time to get to know this wonderful performer and her wonderful group a little better. So we will be talking to the entire band now. So guys, why don't you come on over and we'll have a chat. All right, so in the meantime, let me just say that the music that's been produced so far this morning is amazing. And we seem to have guys, welcome to the show. I'm very happy to have you all on. And it's been an incredible set of music, and I can't wait to hear the rest as we go on. So my first question is for you, Luciana. Why don't you tell us how and when this band was created?
Okay, the Marcano family, Marcano's family, they are both brother and sister. Mm-hmm. So they belong to a big, big family in which Luisea, the guitar player, is also included. And they are living here, fortunately, now. Mm. And we did a Christmas concert with them. And since then, we were hectic for doing something else that could be not only Christmas, but for the whole year and for the whole country music, which they are a treasurer of this music. They have performed this for decades. And so they are our masters and for all the Venezuelans living, musicians living here and also from other countries. And so I convinced them to come here because it's my third program now. Mm-hmm. And I told them how fantastic it is. And so we are very, very happy to have them with us because we received their advice about with the repertoire and the arrangements and everything. So it's basically, we don't have a name yet, but we will. So it's not my band. we're going to be a group because I'm going to convince them. All right. So this is our first non-Christmas concert. Uh-huh. I hope there are going to be many more.
All right. So my next question actually is for Carlos. Carlos, could you explain sort of the process about selecting this particular repertoire of tunes?
So I think that there are in Venezuela a part of our classical music, because the popular music of Venezuela, this is really well known in the world. So, but there is a part of that music that is more in a classical way. Mm. For example, those pieces that we have done before, it's a part of a collection. And in this collection are a lot of Venezuelan regions represented, also genres. And for that reason, we decided to choose one maybe more of one, two or three pieces of this collection, because it's not so regularly performed as the other part of the Venezuelan music. So for that reason, we are doing this part of the classical music.
All right. So this next question sort of goes to all of you, because I think it'll be interesting just to hear the different answers, but. Would you explain sort of how do you go about breathing new life into these folkloric and iconic songs without losing focus of the original meaning of the songs?
Well, I guess most of us have been trained as classical musicians, mm-hmm. but we've been kind of brought up in a country where musical, you know, folk traditions are very strong. So. I don't think it's a big problem just to combine, because we grew up combining all this this classical and the popular genre. So it's just a matter of kind of bringing a new view and a little more kind of organized stylistically, mm-hmm. and you know, in sonority, but in the essence is it keeps the same Venezuelan rhythms, or it's the same Venezuelan style. And you know, and it gives us an enormous possibility to keep creating, you know, above the things that we play, you know, day by day. We play classical music day by day, but when we encounter, we're classical musicians. We're not gonna do the Venezuelan music as folk musicians do, but we just expand this and take it to, we say, take it to a different level, let's say, not another level, but a different level, where all this, the subtleties of the classical music are involved in a traditionally folkloric Venezuelan music.
All right, so how would you explain the process of sort of rearranging and modernizing an otherwise traditional folkloric song?
Well, some of the pieces are arranged by my husband, Luisea, and he loves jazz, and he likes to combine again the harmonies of traditional music, but also put some jazzy chords in it, and I think it's it sounds really very very rich, you know. Yes.
Oh yeah, I mean, just hearing today, I mean, just between with just the cello and the piano together, like you wouldn't know it's just two instruments just by the sound of it, because it's such a full, you know, kind of arrangement. So can you each sort of, you know, can you guys sort of tell us how your music education sort of prepared you for this sort of, for this folkloric repertoire, like sort of how your education sort of helped you in your musical path?
I think the playing music from our country made me more, I think, enriched in my training of classical music. I think most of the classical composers, they take their music from the folk music. So I think it's a very good idea to play, to perform the music of our own, you know, our own music. And I think it's, for me, had been a very nice, a very good training.
All right. So let me see here. So once again, this question sort of opened up to all of you. What advice would you all share with potential students who are looking into making a career in music?
Well, I think nowadays you have to keep your mind open to whatever, you know, is happening. You know, as a classical musician, you should always do, you know, what classicals have to do. You know, all the training, I think that's important, because that's that brings a lot of elements that are not, you know, necessarily present in today's music. But keep your ears open to things that you like, and keep in mind that your upbringing brings you a culture that belongs to you. And in that way, at some point, you know, experimentation, I mean, in, you know, with your training and with your culture and with what's happening, you know, at the same time, will bring something original, which is something that I think really is our mark, you know, as musicians, you know, playing the same as everybody else is playing is, you know, it's nice, but it's not your mark. But if you have your own mark, you know, that combines your culture, your experience, and that will always bring a more, much more interesting product.
All right. So I guess my last question would probably have to be, can you guys tell us a little bit about the song we're going to hear next? I believe it's Quinta Anauco. Anauco. Sorry.
Well, Quinta Anauco is a is a very special house in Caracas. It's a house where Simón Bolívar was spent the last night before he died in Venezuela, because then he died in Colombia, but the last night that he spent in Caracas was in that house. It's a very emblematic, you know, kind of place in Caracas. And the composer Aldemaro Romero, which is very important composer from the Venezuelan popular music and other genres also, dedicated this waltz to this house. You know, it's, most people, you know, write about love and about girls, but he wrote about the house, which was is a very important house for us. So this actually has some lyrics that, you know, playing by cello and piano, are not going to be, you know, you're not going to be able to enjoy. But the actual tune is very interesting because it's a, like, it is like a jazz piece that is composed with the same rhythm. I play the same rhythm, all the same, you know, from the beginning to end. But the notes change, the chords change, so, and that makes it really interesting.
All right. Well, I'm looking forward to hearing it. I'm sure everybody listening now is looking forward to hearing it. So by all means, take it away, guys. All right. So while they're setting up, I just want to remind everyone once again to follow us on the FIU Music and FIU Music Hour Facebook page, and as well as following us on Instagram. And once again, I'd like to remind you, you are listening to WDNA 88.9 FM, with Luciana Kube and her wonderful ensemble playing some great folkloric tunes as well as traditional Venezuelan songs. So, take it away. All right, another beautiful song with a beautiful arrangement. So this next song, Luciana, can you tell us a little more about what we're going to be hearing next?
Yes, next song is called Kirpa Guatireña. The kirpa is a variant from the joropo genre that is originally from the plains of Venezuela. And in this case, kirpa is called kirpa because of a singer that was Kirpa, and he was killed after a performance. Mm. And he was a legendary singer of this type of joropo, and the genre was named after him. And so we are doing a Kirpa that is from the area of the Aragua, that is not in the plains, but was composed in honor of this place too, like it's a Kirpa from Guatire, Kirpa Guatireña. Mm. And it's very, very rich, and it's funny too. I think you will find rewarding to listen to it.
Temple de Kirpa en el arpa, para cantar con placer, desde que el sol va muriendo hasta que vuelve a nacer. Temple de Kirpa en el arpa, para cantar con placer. Damas está encantarrona, cuéntate en los barrancos. Damas o berroterón, improvisa lo que canta. En el llano canta claro, custodio que endo en Aragua. Damas o canta su tierra, la Kirpa de cantarrona. Temple de Kirpa en el arpa, para cantar con placer, desde que el sol va muriendo y hasta que vuelve a nacer. Temple de Kirpa en el arpa, para cantar con placer. Juan Santiago, no te enojes porque te digan negrito. Negros fueron los tres clavos con que clavaron a Cristo. Negra fue Santa Efigenia, negro fue San Benedito, negros con los ojos negros de mi negra Rosarito. Temple de Kirpa en el arpa, para cantar con placer, desde que el sol va muriendo hasta que vuelve a nacer. Temple de Kirpa en el arpa, para cantar con placer. Cuando cantó al pie del arpa, se oye el volar del tallío. Y como avispa en trapiche, se aglomera el gentío. Escobilla en menudeo y zapatea en tronío, la mañana joropera cuando canta el pecho mío. Temple de Kirpa en el arpa, para cantar con placer, desde que el sol va muriendo y hasta que vuelve a nacer. Temple de Kirpa en el arpa, para cantar con placer.
Germán Marcano, Clara Marcano, thank you so much.
All right, so another wonderful song. And what we have up next, I believe, is Mañanita Caraqueña. I believe that's what the pronunciation. All right. And it's composed by Evancio Castellanos. Castellanos, and we have Clara Marcano on piano, Germán Marcano on cello, and Carlos Silva on vocals. Oh, it's just Clara. It's just Clara. All right, Clara Marcano, take it away. right. So that was another wonderful, wonderful song. And I think that's always why piano has been one of my favorite instruments, just because there's so much emotion that can be put through just by playing. So, all right. So next song, I believe, is Desesperanza. What can you tell us about it, Carlos?
Yes, Desesperanza is without hope. And this is a really famous song in Venezuela because it was performed for one of our greatest singers ever, Alfredo Sadel. Mm-hmm. And this is from a composer, María Luisa Escobar, and it's dedicated to her son. So, Desesperanza.
All right.
Nunca me iré de tu vida, ni tú de mi corazón. Aunque por otros caminos nos lleve el destino, ¿qué importa a los dos? Te llevo dentro del alma como un tatuaje de sol. Venas palpita la llama encendida de tu corazón. En una noche callada te fuiste y no has vuelto. Mi vida entera te llama y anhela tus besos. Labios ardientes y con el alma encendida a volverme la vida que un día te llevaste con mi corazón. Callada, te fuiste y no has vuelto. Mi vida entera te llama y anhela tus besos míos. ¿Es que tú acaso no escuchas mi grito doliente, la voz de mi alma que anhela tu amor? Que vuelvas con tus labios ardientes y con el alma encendida a volverme la vida que un día te llevaste con mi corazón, con mi corazón.
That was Desesperanza. What an amazing song, amazing vocals, wonderfully arranged. All right, so before we go on to the next song, I'd like to thank you for spending your time with us today. As we come to the conclusion of the FIU Music Hour here on WDNA, I would like to remind you that if you know anyone interested in pursuing a music career, please direct them to our website, music.fiu.edu, or have them call 305-348-2896 for more information. Also, do not forget to like us on Facebook and Instagram under FIU Music. I'm your host, Colin Miller, and along with our producer, Dr. Karen Fuller-Veloz, we'd like to thank our production crew, Andrea Leon, Maria Fernandez-Sobera, Paul Steinsland, Alex Audrich, Angel Rojas, Beatrice Guzman, Camilo Perez, Mariana Fernandez, Orlando Haddock, and Raquel Garcia. Next week, we will be presenting Neapolitan. Come join us live at the WDNA Jazz Gallery or on the radio for some more great music on the FIU Music Hour. And here is once more Luciana Kube and her wonderful ensemble. The airwaves are all yours.
Thank you. We're going to perform La Perica.
Cuando la perica quiere que el perico vaya a misa, se levanta muy temprano a plancharle la camisa. Cuando la perica quiere que el perico vaya a misa, se levanta muy temprano a plancharle la camisa. Ay, mi perico, dame la pata para ponerte las alpargatas. Ay, mi perico, ven acá y dame la pata para ponerte las alpargatas. Cuando la perica quiere que el perico la enamore, se acomoda en la pechuga un collar de cunde amores. Cuando la perica quiere que el perico la enamore, se acomoda en la pechuga un collar de cunde amores. Ay, mi perico, dame la pata para ponerte las alpargatas. Ay, mi perico, ven acá y dame la pata para ponerte las alpargatas. Cuando la perica quiere que la bese su perico, coquetón abre las alas y adormece y abre el pico. Cuando la perica quiere que la bese su perico, coquetón abre las alas y adormece y abre el pico. Ay, mi perico, dame la pata para ponerte las alpargatas. Ay, mi perico, ven acá y dame la pata para ponerte las alpargatas.
And the cuatro, also with Carlos.
Well, it seems that we have time for one more number, if that's possible.
So we can do El Norte es una quimera.
Once again, you're listening to the FIU Music Hour here on WDNA with Luciana Kube and her wonderful ensemble.
So the arrangement is also made by Luisa, and it's a Luis Fragachan song.
Nueva York en busca de unos centavos y he regresado a Caracas como fuerte de arrear pavos. El norte es una quimera, qué atrocidad, y dice que allá se vive como un pachá. Ay, Nueva York, no me halagas con el oro, tu ley seca la rechazo, no me agrada y la deploro. Ay, Nueva York, yo allá no voy. Allá no hay vino, no hay perro, no hay guayabón. Ay, Nueva York, no me halagas con el oro, tu ley seca la rechazo, no me agrada y la deploro. Ay, Nueva York, yo allá no voy. Allá no hay vino, no hay perro y no hay amor. Todo el que va a Nueva York se pone tan embustero que si allá lavaba platos dice aquí que era platero. El norte es una quimera, qué atrocidad, y dicen que allá se vive ahí como un pachá. Todo el que va a Nueva York se pone tan embustero que si allá lavaba platos dice aquí que era platero. El norte es una quimera, qué atrocidad, y dice Jamaica ya se vive, ay, como un pachá. Ay, Nueva York, no me halagas con el oro, tu ley seca la rechazo, no me agrada y la deploro. Ay, Nueva York, yo allá no voy, allá no hay vino, no hay perro, no hay amor. Ay, Nueva York, no me halagas con el oro, tu ley seca la rechazo, no me agrada y la deploro. Ay, Nueva York, yo allá no voy, allá no hay vino, no hay perro y no hay amor. No vuelvo pa' Nueva York, lo juro por San Andrés. No me gusta hablar inglés ni montar en ascensor. El norte es una quimera, qué atrocidad. Y dicen que allá se vive, ay, como un pachá. No vuelvo pa' Nueva York, lo juro por San Andrés. No me gusta hablar inglés ni montar en ascensor. El norte es una quimera, qué atrocidad. Y dicen que allá se vive como un pachá. Ay, Nueva York, no me halagas con el oro, tu ley seca la rechazo, no me agrada y la deploro. Ay, Nueva York, yo allá no voy, allá no hay vino, no hay perro, no hay amor. Ay, Nueva York, no me halagas con el oro, tu ley seca la rechazo, no me agrada y la deploro. Ay, Nueva York, yo allá no voy, allá no hay vino, no hay perro, no hay amor.